At 6, gas prices, home heating, free bus service, and pandemic hero pay. Lawmakers right now are tackling these issues during a special session.
And Chief Political Reporter Susan Raff is live at the state capitol, where, Susan, it has been a very busy day.
A busy day, but there's definitely a big interest to do something, and it's coming from both sides. Energy costs are through the roof right now, and it's only expected to get possibly even worse. And they want to do something before the winter sets in. Right now, the House has already passed the emergency measure, and the Senate will take it up tonight. Lawmakers are negotiating a deal to make things a little more affordable this winter.
We've got a special session today that I believe is going to make a real difference in mitigating the high cost of energy.
There is some relief to help families struggling with fuel costs, an additional $30 million into LIHEAP, a program to help low-income families, plus $4.5 million into Operation Fuel. An added bonus, Eversource is putting in $10 million, United Illuminating, $3 million. Governor Lamont says he convinced the utility companies to pitch in, considering electric rates are going up about $85 a month because of gas supply issues.
The goal is to get customers the ability to pay an affordable rate.
Lawmakers admit this is a short-term solution.
We do need to look a bit more intentional about the long-term ability of the state to procure energy at affordable costs, but I mean, this is a national issue.
There's also some relief at the gas pump. Lawmakers want to keep the 25-cent gas tax suspended for another month. After that, add 5 cents more each month to get back to 25. The bill they're voting on also keeps bus service free until April 1st. And puts more money into the pandemic relief fund. Private sector workers were promised bonuses, but the fund is running out of money because more people applied than expected. Republican leaders say they'll support these relief measures, but feel they fall short of what's needed.
It's great that the energy companies are stepping up to supplement some energy payments, but it's going to amount to about $5 on someone's energy bill. Let's start having real conversations about piping gas into Connecticut.
All of these emergency measures were put into one bill, which passed the House overwhelmingly today, and it is expected to pass in the Senate. Yes, Republicans say they would have liked to see more relief, as certainly the payments that go out to families, and Democrats agree that more is needed. But right now, both sides agree that they have to do something now. We're live at the state capitol. Susan Raff, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.